In this video, we are going to take a look at how we can use the draft tool to create face draft angles in Autodesk Inventor. I'll begin by starting the draft command, which is here on the 3D model tab in the modify panel. Here's draft right there. I'll go ahead and select it. And there's three basic ways to create a draft. The first one is a fixed edge. And with this one, the first thing that I'll do is choose a pull direction. So to think about the pull direction, one of the reasons why we might use face drafts is for castings. And when you make castings, you have to have a slight angle to the part so that it'll slide out of the casting. So that's where the idea of the pull direction comes from. If I'm wanting this to slope out, then my pull direction is going to be vertically. So I'm going to choose a vertical edge here. Then I can choose the faces that I want to add this to. So if I select this face here, you can see that it's going to go out. In this case, I'm going to hit the flip button to flip it the other direction. I can also continue adding more faces. Notice that automatic face chain is on. So when I select this surface because of the tangent edges, you can see that it continues on around the part. I'll undo this and jump back in there again to look at some other options here. I didn't mention it earlier, but of course, here's where you can change the draft angle. Another method that we have is the fixed plane method. Personally, I kind of like this one because I feel like it gives me more control over the way the draft works. So going back to the pull direction here, if I select this vertical edge as my pull direction, and then this face as the one that's going to slope, you can see that basically what's happening here is it's picked the top edge and this top surface isn't changing and this is angling in or out from there. But what if I wanted that bottom surface to be the one that stayed the same size and I wanted it to slope in from there? Well, that's where we can use the fixed plane tool. With the fixed plane tool, what you're going to do is click on the plane that is going to remain exactly the same. So if I want the bottom surface to stay the same, I'm going to click on the bottom surface. Now I'll choose the faces that I want to add the slope to. So I'll go ahead and choose all the faces around the part here. Now notice that as it does this, that the bottom shape remains the same size and it is sloping out as it goes up. If I hit the flip arrow, it slopes in as it goes up. So that bottom shape never changes. I can even choose a different plane. It doesn't have to be the top or the bottom. So I could choose, for example, the plane running through the center of the part. Then if I select the faces, now what's happening is right at that midsection, that is staying the same size that it was. It slopes in as it goes up and out as it goes down. Similarly, we can slope using a middle plane or another parting line and actually have it slope two different directions. So I'll choose the third option here, parting line. And I'll start with a pull direction. So it's similar to that first method where I've got to choose a pull direction. So I'm going to choose one of my vertical edges here. Then I have to select a parting tool. So this is a little more like the second option where I want to click on a plane. I'll choose the middle plane here. Then I'll choose the faces that I want to apply this to. So I'll go ahead and select all the faces around the part again. And I'll go ahead and increase this draft angle a little more dramatically so you can really see the difference here. So notice now that the center plane stays exactly the same, and now it slopes in both directions. So I'll go ahead and click OK, and now you can see the end result of that particular part. So once more to recap, three different ways to create drafts. And this is a handy tool whether you're just wanting to add an angle to a surface or if you're doing a casting and you want to add a draft angle to several surfaces at the same time. That concludes this look at the face draft tool in Autodesk Inventor.